Whoa, what's them? Today's video is titled Kendrick Perkins Stands for What? Now, if you new here, what the fuck we do here is read, listen, watch, and we block talk, break that shit down. And of course, we gonna start with our ignorance disclaimer. If you think the blood of your firstborn gonna fall from the sky when you hear a cursed word, you should leave now. We only want the mature minded, goddammit. If you believe I'm hating on Kendrick Perkins or I'm hating on ESPN, you should also leave now. We only want the mature minded, goddammit. You are witnessing the Rebel Network, and yes, Kendrick Perkins is the latest surrogate of the NBA to speak out against Kyrie Irving, who said he's not playing basketball until things change in America. But Kendrick Perkins, being a surrogate of the NBA, spoke out against him, y'all, and you know why. Because it's big business over everything. It's pocket lining over everything. It's bag chasing over everything. Do y'all see it now? And I know how some of y'all think, goddammit. I'm not telling you not to be prosperous. You understand me? I'm not telling you not to be prosperous. But if it conflict with your morals and values, not only do you need to reevaluate your next step, but you need to reevaluate who you are as a person, y'all. But you know the red flags to knowing who these paid surrogate is, who these paid surrogates are, goddammit, or who these paid plants is, goddammit. They'll say shit like this: they don't have a plan around this bitch. They'll be so upset that somebody don't have a plan. And I've been in the military, y'all. When somebody in command say go hit that hill, you don't get mad because you don't know the rest of the plan. You go for yours, goddammit. You hit that motherfucking hill and shoot until you can't shoot no more. And you'll get to the next step when we get there, when everybody hit the flow. You understand what the fuck I'm saying here? But y'all gonna know these stupid ass plans, because they'll also be mad about some shit like this: you didn't speak to the Players Association and all of that old bullshit. Man, motherfuck the Players Association. Y'all know who run that shit? Michelle Roberts. Guess what her job was before this shit? She was a goddamn public defender. You know what the hell that mean? We know how great public defenders are in the black community. We know how awesome public defenders are. These are some of the best people on earth. The way that they take these cases and they win, goddammit, they get so much justice in the black community. Do y'all understand? Do you see the sarcasm, goddammit, through the anger and frustration in my voice? But you know what else they gonna fucking say, y'all? This only gonna hurt the black community, goddammit. No, the fuck is not. Because when you had your lockout and the players was divided, it didn't hurt us at all. Some of us didn't even know there was a lockout, goddammit, like me, because I'm not the biggest NBA fan around this bitch. But guess what, y'all? Of course, we gonna break down old what's his name, Kendrick Perkins, and you gonna see all the red flags, because that's what the fuck we do here at BTN. Play the first clip.
If you take Kyrie Irving's brain and put it in a bird right now, guess what that bird is gonna do?
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna fly backwards. Because Kyrie right now, he's confused. He's showing his lack of leadership.
As y'all could see, Kendrick Perkins decided to lead off with a motherfucking insult, y'all. He decided to lead off with an insult. Do y'all understand he just made that man's brain equivalent to an animal? In fact, he made that man's brain below that of an animal, because he said if you take the bird's brain out and put Kyrie Irving's brain in, the bird, meaning the animal, will fly backwards. So even as an animal, even functioning as an animal, Kyrie Irving would not know how to function. He would not know that as a bird you fly forward, goddammit. Do you see what the hell he just did to that man on national TV and got the cheeks to say that Kyrie Irving is fucking confused? No, you are confused, young man. You are goddamn confused. You flying backwards around this bitch. Now tell me this, y'all. Is there a lack of leadership when you gather your peers for a common cause, that being the loss of black lives on the fucking planet Earth? Is that a display of a lack of leadership? Or do you think what the fuck Kendrick Perkins just did was a lack of maturity? Did he just display a lack of maturity by insulting that fucking man, goddammit? But let's play this clip, then we'll play the next clip so you get the full gist. You know how we do, goddammit.
If you take Kyrie Irving brain and put it in a bird right now, guess what that bird is gonna do?
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna fly backwards. Because Kyrie right now, he's confused. He's showing his lack of leadership.
Fake ass boy. Here's the next clip.
And you have been on the phone and you have voted to play. And also we go back last week. Just last week, he was reaching out to the Players Association and the NBA about, you know, players that are on the inactive list. Can they travel to Orlando? That he said he wanted to go to Orlando and be part of the team and be with his team and be a leader.
You are witnessing the Rebel Network. Do y'all understand what's taking place here? This dude is making an attempt to dirty up Kyrie Irving's image to you, goddammit. He wants you to think that, oh, just a week ago, just a second ago, you was voting to play. You was voting to do this. You was ready to do this. And you wanted to lead, remember? He was telling that Players Association that he wanted to be with his team and that he was ready to go out there and lead. Y'all remember that? God damn it. But y'all see how he tried to dirty him up, right? But when that man was speaking about coming back, guess what they was talking about? Corona. And Kendrick Perkins is about to expose that in case you, you know, think I'm bullshitting, god damn it. He was talking about coming back during the corona epidemic or pandemic, whatever the hell you want to call the old bullshit, and I ain't even gonna get into that. But that's what that man was speaking on. This was before the goddamn riots or the kickout of the goddamn riots or protests or whatever. Either way is acceptable to me, goddammit. But pay attention to what's going on. You trying to dirty that fucking man image up, goddammit. But he said he wanted to be with his team and be a leader. When he said be a leader, you don't know what the fuck he was talking about. Maybe he wanted to help with the quote-unquote pandemic. And if the protests or riots has started, goddammit, maybe he wanted to be a leader on that forefront. What the fuck are you talking about, goddammit? But we gonna play that clip and we gonna get to the next one that further exposes old Kendrick Perkins, why he think he's snitching on people and dirtying up their image to prove his point.
And you have been on the phone and you have voted to play. And also we go back last week, just last week, he was reaching out to the Players Association and the NBA about, you know, players that are on the inactive list, can they travel to Orlando? That he said he wanted to go to Orlando and be part of the team and be with his team and be a leader.
Here's the next clip.
From what I was told, the NBA said, no, you can't go because of the pandemic and coronavirus situation, that the people, the bodies that are there are bodies that, you know, are that need to be people in place to, you know, take part in action.
Boy, this dude here can barely fucking talk, goddamn it. Got the cheeks to go and speak out against somebody who trying to stand on something. Your dumb ass can barely motherfucking talk. You saying all kind of incoherent shit, goddamn it. Y'all heard this fucking fool? From what he was told, the NBA told Kyrie Irving, a grown ass man, that you can't go down there and be with your team and shit, you dig? All the bodies that's down there, that's bodies that's meant to be down there for action. And understand the number one thing, y'all. The number one thing is that you grown ass men gotta contact the NBA whenever you're trying to move from state to state. They gotta approve everything with you clowns. Don't that show you how much your public defender got done? The public defender didn't say, hey, these is grown men, and if they off the clock, they can do whatever the fuck they want. Y'all can't even fight to get that with your lame ass. You understand? Them people told you, no, you not going to Florida to be a leader or none of that shit, goddammit. We don't care if you're handing out masks. And to understand, y'all, why Kyrie Irving, remember they said that he reached out. Remember he said, man, when he thought he was snitching on that man, man, you was voting to play. You was ready to play, goddammit. What did y'all just not hear the NBA respond to? The NBA said because of the coronavirus, the pandemic, his dumbass said the coronavirus and the pandemic, that's the same thing. But because of the coronavirus, you can't go down there. understand that they didn't say because of the supposed riots or because of the protests and because of the racial climate, you can't go down there. Now y'all understand that this shit was way before the fucking riots. And when the dude was contacting them saying, man, I'm ready to play, that was because of the fucking coronavirus, goddammit. But he tried to dirty the man image up, y'all. I told y'all, they trying to shape your motherfucking image. But let's replay this shit so you let that shit sink in and we gonna get to the next clip, goddammit.
From what I was told, the NBA said, no, you can't go because of the pandemic and the coronavirus situation, that the people, the bodies that are there are bodies that, you know, that need to be people in place to, you know, take part in action.
On to the next one.
And so, in my opinion, when you look at Kyrie, I'm okay with you changing your mind and having a different way of thinking and saying, you know what, we need to make a stance, but and sit out. But what is the plan after that? He didn't have one. So once again, that showed his lack of leadership, Greeny.
You are witnessing the Rebel Network, and y'all see this dude still going with the fucking narrative that the man changed his mind, y'all. He's still going with that narrative after we established that the man was talking about the coronavirus. This was not during the time of George Floyd when the man was ready to come back and play basketball for you motherfuckers. But you know why he going with that narrative? Because he paid to, goddammit. They paid him to go with that narrative. Do you see it now, goddammit? Then he continued and said, oh, it's a different way of thinking and saying that you need to take a stance. Pay attention to his body language, because the whole clip, he was shaking his shoulders and shit, moving his head around. He was dismissive, if you ask me, goddammit. But that's my opinion. And then what he did, he threw out the red flag. He said, but even though he taking a stance and he changed his mind, supposedly, and all of that bullshit, I can't mess with you because you don't got a plan. Because you don't have a fucking plan. He can't rock with you. And on top of that, it shows a lack of leadership. Yet this motherfucker is showing a lack of a backbone because he stands for nothing. He stands for nothing except for what the fuck they pay him to stand for. Fake ass boys, while y'all up there worrying and thinking somebody clout chasing. These motherfuckers bag chasing, and that shit is costing us lives. Young lives, old lives, male and fucking female, goddammit. Play this stupid ass clip, then play the next clip.
And so, in my opinion, when you look at Kyrie, I'm okay with you changing your mind and having a different way of thinking and saying, you know what, we need to make a stance, but and sit out. But what is the plan after that? He didn't have one. So once again, that showed his lack of leadership, Greeny.
Next.
Two people have been lynched in the state of Texas. A young African-American young lady was killed in Akron, Ohio, behind a hate crime. And have that been highlighted like it should have been? No, because for the last 2 days, we have been talking about Kyrie Irving. So Kyrie Irving, right now, you are the distraction. You are the distractor. You distracting the whole situation.
You are witnessing the Rebel Network. Did y'all hear him? He just now blamed Kyrie Irving for there not being enough coverage of Nakia Crawford being murdered as a fucking hate crime in Akron, Ohio. Y'all know how many fucking channels they have in America? Do you know how many cable news channels they have? Do you know how many hours are in a day where they repeat the same fucking story over and over? But this paid, dirty motherfucker got the cheeks to blame that one man for single-handedly taking all the coverage away from Nakia Crawford, who he didn't even fucking know by name, because he don't even know how to publicize her fucking murder, the hate crime towards her, goddammit. Y'all know when I get mad, I go to stumbling over the fucking words and shit. But he didn't even know the fucking girl name. Say her fucking name, you idiot, while you up there blaming that man for stealing coverage. You don't even know her fucking name. You're probably didn't even investigate it, because on the slick, it looked like you're probably reading, or your dumbass was coached before you went out there, and they probably just told your lame ass to make it your own round here. One of them type of motherfuckers. But he just blamed that fucking man for there not being enough coverage of other murders of black people, and got the cheeks to raise his motherfucking hand and point into the fucking camera, y'all, and say that that man is the distractor. He the distractor. He the problem. But have you ever seen this fake motherfucker come out in defense of any black lives being lost on this planet? You ever saw him point his finger out and say, you motherfuckers is wrong for killing people? You ever saw him that passionate after a clear unjust fucking murder? No. And you ain't gonna see him, and you ain't gonna see T.I., and you ain't gonna see Jerry Rice, and you ain't gonna see Trina, or none of these fucking puppets who's showing their true colors these days, goddammit. Now play his whack ass clip again, and then we gonna get to the next video to break his ass down further.
Two people have been lynched in the state of Texas. Young African-American young lady was killed in Akron, Ohio, behind a hate crime. And have that been highlighted like it should have been? No, because for the last 2 days, we have been talking about Kyrie Irving. So Kyrie Irving, right now, you are the distraction. You are the distractor. You distracting the whole situation.
Next.
You know, you come out and you do something separately without talking to your president, Chris Paul, or consulting with Michelle Roberts, and go off and do something totally different and get a group of guys together and say, let's sit out without a plan. It makes zero sense, and I totally disagree with Kyrie Irving.
As y'all could see, that boy just not doubled down on his defense of the NBA, talking about that man decided to do something separate. As y'all could see, when them boys signed that contract, they can't do a motherfucking thing. How about I clocked out, goddammit? I'm off the job, and I decided I ain't going back to the job with a group of employees I work with. Y'all understand what I'm saying? I decided with a group of employees while we was off the clock that we ain't going back to motherfucking work until shit changed. Look what his dumb ass gonna say though. Oh, you and a group of dudes had got together and said we gonna sit out without no plan. See, he keep on attaching that no plan shit. We already debunked that, so I ain't even gonna say shit about the bullshit plan red flag, goddammit. But he went on to say, y'all, that it makes zero sense. Bro, how the fuck it make zero sense? It don't even make a percentage of sense that the dude took a stance against human lives being lost. It don't make not even 1%, y'all, not even 1% of sense that the man is standing out because lives are being lost. Wow. And y'all notice with these surrogates, all of them come out and say they completely disagree with Kyrie Irving, like Stephen A. Smith. I emphatically disagree. And now we hear him saying what? I totally disagree with Kyrie Irving. We know you do by this point with your buck dancing ass, goddammit. I don't even know Kendrick Perkins like that, but this dude look like a total fucking buffoon. Play the next clip after we play this clip.
You know, you come out and you do something separately without talking to your president, Chris Paul, or consulting with Michelle Roberts, and go off and do something totally different and get a group of guys together and say, let's sit out without a plan. It makes zero sense, and I totally disagree with Kyrie Irving.
New clip.
Are you concerned right now, Kendrick, that the players are being divided by this issue?
Yes, I am, Greeny, because, listen, and one point only. For the players that decide to go, you have a small group of people behind Kyrie Irving, and God bless their heart, like those old people used to say.
Now, did y'all hear this fucking clown? How he insulted the people who decided not to play basketball, who decided to stand with Kyrie, goddammit, who saying we not dribbling and shooting no more until these motherfuckers make change? You heard how he insulted them, talking about God bless their souls, God bless their heart, or whatever the fuck his dumb ass said. But you know what he was trying to imply? That they don't know what the fuck they doing. They just following him. Forgive them for they know not what they do type shit. You understand me? Them fucking dudes took a stance. And by being a small group, all that let us know is that majority of you dribbling ass niggas is out there cooning, goddammit, doing whatever you can and saying whatever you gotta say and throwing whatever black person under the motherfucking bus, goddammit. Just like this motherfucking clown. And look how disrespectful he is, gonna say, just like those old people used to say. No fucking respect. He ain't say, just like my elders used to say. No shit like that, because he lack respect, y'all. He lack maturity. He lack a backbone, but got the cheeks to talk about leadership lacking around this bitch. Boy, if you don't sit your silly ass down, show this clip again, let that shit sink in, and we gonna get to the next one.
Are you concerned right now, Kendrick, that the players are being divided by this issue?
Yes, I am, Greeny, because listen, and one point only, for the players that decide to go, you have a small group of people behind Kyrie Irving, and God bless their heart, like those old people used to say.
New clip.
But the players who decide to go to Disney, a lot of those players are going to be frowned upon, especially in the African-American community, because they're not educated, and they're going to say, oh, y'all shouldn't have played. Y'all should have made a stance. Stance for what? And stayed home?
Yeah. Yeah, you heard his motherfucking ass. You are witnessing the Rebel Network. He laid up there and said that the players who decide to come back and go to Disney and shit, they gonna be ridiculed, y'all. By who? The uneducated African-American. Because y'all too stupid that you gonna say, hey, why y'all ain't make a stance? Because we all know how stupid that is. How dumb could we possibly be to try to make a stance? How uneducated of us. We so damn stupid. We think that making a stance is a good thing, huh? Us uneducated niggas down here, because we know you high up on the hog. You done got sedity with it, huh? You out there in Brentwood, huh? You understand what he doing? You understand how he view us, goddammit? And it's just how they always is, goddammit. Look what he got on, his suit. Just like that little motherfucker Young Jeezy and whoever else they try to get to fool you. Now he's a politician. We should listen to Kendrick Perkins, because he got a gray suit on, y'all. If you don't sit your huggy bear looking ass down, boy, stupid ass. Y'all see what I'm talking about here? Do y'all see these motherfucking frauds? We so fucking stupid that we gonna think they should have took a stance. Ain't that a bitch? That they should have took a stance for our life. Play the next clip.
But the players who decide to go to Disney, a lot of those players are gonna be frowned upon, especially in the African-American community, because they're not educated, and they're gonna say, oh, y'all shouldn't have played. Y'all should have made a stance. Stands for what? And stayed home?
New clip.
Who are you hurting? You're not hurting the owners. You're hurting the athletes, the African Americans, 80% who make 80% of the players that make up the NBA that could get extra money to provide back into the African American community. So yes, I do think it divides the player union that, by the way, has been strong as I ever seen it in my 17 years of being around the NBA.
Yeah, y'all see how that boy is? You witnessing the Rebel Network. You see how passionate that boy is when he defending the NBA around this bitch? When he defending the NBA owners, y'all? Now, when it came to making a stance, how was his tone? He was like, oh, it's all right. You know, a different way of thinking. You decided to make a stance. But when he defending them, he like, who you think you fucking with, goddammit? Who you think you hurting? That boy bust out for a big business, goddammit. He representing for the NBA owners, huh? You ain't hurting them. Then he gonna say, you just hurting the 80% African-American players who gonna donate to the community with their extra money. Their extra money, huh? Fake-ass boys. Now think about this, y'all. The NBA been around. These dudes been playing, goddammit. What effect have they had? We already know that the motherfuckers control who y'all donate to. We already discussed how your grown ass can't even speak out on your own, or how you can't go from state to state on your own. Your dumb ass can't just go and say, I'm donating to this or donating to that. That's why we always see y'all donate with Make a Wish with number snowflakes around your ass, or the Boys and Girls Club of Brentwood around this bitch with number snowflakes around your ass, you did. Come on now, y'all. We live in these neighborhoods. We know that we don't see these NBA players. They don't even drive through and give away shirts or none of that. Do they even come back like I told y'all how the Jews do, who set up banks and give loans at 0%, goddammit? Because I know how you think, some idiot saying, see, they just want a handout. Y'all always expect these people to just give y'all something. Well, guess what the Jews doing? Giving loans and shit, 0% interest to their community. They fucking kind. Why you worrying about somebody looking for a handout? It's about giving back, motherfucker. But you know where they gonna be at? Boys and Girls Club, Make a Wish. That's it, goddamn it. That's a motherfucking shame. But this fake ass boy gonna tell us, you're only hurting yourself. Ain't that the other red flag, y'all? See, I ain't even catch this while going through the video, but that's another red flag. That fool just done said, you're only hurting yourself. That's what the fuck he just said. I'm gonna play that video and we'll get to the next.
Who are you hurting? You're not hurting the owners. You're hurting the hurting the athletes, the African Americans, 80% who make 80% of the players that make up the NBA that could get extra money to provide back into the African American community. So yes, I do think it divides the player union that, by the way, has been strong as I ever seen it in my 17 years of being around the NBA.
New clip. You are witnessing the Rebel Network. My bad, y'all. During the editing and breaking this fool down, I laid up there and forgot that this was the last clip around this bitch, you dig? But y'all know the overall message? All of these people on TV are suspect until further notice, goddammit. If they come out there talking about Sears or Target, they pay for by Sears or Target. They speaking up for the NBA or NFL, they pay by the motherfuckers, goddammit. They all paid operatives. Stephen A. Smith, paid operative, paid plant, paid surrogate, goddammit. This motherfucker, Kendrick Perkins, Trina, all of them, Denzel Washington, pick one. All of these people are suspect until further notice. And if you can't accept that, goddammit, in a minute, you ain't even gonna be able to accept life. Once again, y'all holler at me.